Welcome to Shark Aero Company and our Slovak factory where we produce Shark airplanes. My name is Peter Hill. I'm in charge of sales and marketing, and let me show you around. This is where we started 30 years ago, producing carbon composite parts, at that time for diamond aircraft. These days, we produce parts for our own aircraft, called Shark. And this is where the whole production of the aircraft starts. Altogether, there are around 200 composite parts in our airplanes. All of them produced here. Perhaps this is one of the most complex parts that we produce in this section. It's a Kevlar cage that is glued inside of the carbon airframe of the airplane to protect the crew in case of any accident. Now we are in the rough assembly section of the Shark production. Here the composite parts are glued together, fitted and prepared for the next stage, which is back there, and it's the paint section. The aircraft is designed according to the European ultralight or microlight category, so it is very light indeed. When the aircraft is completed, it weighs around 350 kilograms or 770 pounds. Altogether nowadays, we produce 3 airplanes in the rough assembly per month, but we are aiming to get to 4 airplanes per month. Altogether, that will be about 50 airplanes per year. This is the final stage of production of Shark, the final assembly. Here, all the components are put together, including the electrical systems and avionics, parachute, and later on, the engine. After that, we do the test flight, and aircraft is ready for delivery. And by the way, quite a few of the parts used here are 3D printed.
My name is Vladimir Pekar. I am CEO of company SHARK.AERO, and we are now in a room where we run the 3D printers. All our printers in company are Prusa printers. We are a composite specialist company, so most of the process was to make composite part. The smaller part and more complicated, it takes time, and for this part is absolutely best to use 3D printing. Today we are printing 100 parts which we then install to aircraft, and I estimate we save maybe 100 work hours with this. All on these plates are parts we more or less install to aircraft. We don't print parts which are primary structure, and for instance we have on aircraft landing gear doors. I was fighting with this about 10 years. And I solved it finally thanks to 3D printer. Mostly we work with ABS because of quite good temperature resistance. It reached near 100 degrees because aircraft is exposed to the sun, sometimes canopy is closed, and really temperatures can go quite high. Some parts which we have in motor cooling we print with nylon. Some small details are even with PETG and PLA, but these are really details which are not in reality installed in aircraft. We are printing the grips on the control stick and the throttle, and in the past we produced it with casting polyurethane to silicone molds. but it needs quite a lot of labor, quite a lot of work, plus the silicon mold had limited life and it was very difficult to produce a new one. So especially for these parts I bought the laser printer. MK4 is the new, we have it here maybe 3 weeks. Really to use it massively we need to reslice our models. So I expect it will bring new quality with first layer and more user-friendly qualities. We are in aircraft. Most of the parts which we print is not visible. They are hidden somewhere below instrument panel in the structure of aircraft, but it's possible to see the grips on the control stick and on the throttle and just some small details in the interior is visible. Here we have landing gear doors for aircraft. It took me maybe 10 years to solve all problems around, and finally I was able to do it really thanks to 3D printing. Doors give us about 10 km higher cruise speed on the aircraft. So 3D printing we don't use only for the parts for serial aircraft, but we use it as well for some tools, molds, master models. This is one of the probably biggest work which we made on the mold. This is a mold from for front fork. So this part was printed in on printer. From PLA, then we made a finish on it. Mold was assembled. We produced to this mold first masterpiece, and from this masterpiece we finally produced a serial mold, which is composite and really hard enough for running serial production with the metal inserts and so on and so on.
This is the most famous shark we've produced so far. This is the one that Zara Rutherford, as the youngest woman in history, flew around the world solo, getting several Guinness World Records. For us, the key was not the PR around it, but the fact that it proved the reliability of the airplane to be able to fly everywhere in the world in any climate imaginable. It's an ideal tool for traveling or for just flying for fun, because flying is a really addictive passion.